your team. At this time, we ask you to please rise as we honor America as our Spice World Cup band will play our national anthem.
Ooh, I can't hear anything. It is just like static. Yeah. Super static.
The Lady Dons are coached by Coach Alyssa Larson. Starting tonight for the Lady Dons, double zero, Taylor Stewart.
Welcome to Spanish Fork 17. This is the Spanish Fork Dons up against the Dixie Flyers. This is the 4A Girls Basketball State Tournament. This is round one. The winner of this one will be heading over to Cedar City for the rest of the tournament. Thank you for being with us here on Spanish Fork 17. Sorry for the technical difficulties at the beginning of this broadcast, but we have this awesome playoff basketball game for you. It is the Spanish Fork Dons up against the Dixie Flyers. This is the first round of the 4A Girls Basketball State Tournament. As the Dons were able to finish second in their region this year, the Flyers of Dixie finished third. The winner of this one will be heading over to Cedar City and will be playing the winner of the Ridgeline versus Juan Diego game. That will be live on our network here, Channel 17 on Spanish Fork, but it will also be available online courtesy of KSL on Deseret Digital. And here we go, here is the tip-off of this one. For the Dons, the key to their offense is gonna be their two-headed monster. It is Taylor Stewart and Eliza Bowman that have led the offense so far for the Dons. Bowman averages around 17 a game. For Stewart, it's around 14. So they will need big games from both of those girls if they want to win this one. And there is the tip-off, and it is controlled by the Flyers. With the ball for the Flyers is number 10, that's Sina Swalger. Has kicked it over to number 3, that is Jocelyn Bundy. Oh, a near steal there by the Dons, but it is recovered nicely there by Mel Alou, the center for the Flyers. Is back to Swalger. Drives into the lane, kicks it out. Jump shot is in. Beautiful mid-range jumper there by Sina Tapasa. As the Flyers draw first blood in this one, a beautiful trap there on defense that ends up forcing the turnover. The press defense of the Flyers gets to the Lady Dons on that first possession. So the score is still 2-0. Again, both teams really were very impressive this year for the Dons. Again, they finished second in their region. Oh, a nice pass and up. That is 4 points for the Flyers. And specifically 4 points for Tapasa. As that is the Dons bringing the ball up. Stewart hands it over to Bowman. Gets it up and in. Nice job there by Erica Allen. My apologies. The point guard for the Dons. Nice layup and a good feed. Score is now 4-2, and there is a foul on the floor. That's going to be actually on the shot. Looks like they're going to call Stewart on that foul. And they are going to call that one on the floor. Looks like they may have called it a shooting foul. Inbounded. A nice pass and another mid-range jumper. This one by Mel Alou. An early 6-2 lead here for the Flyers as the Dons are really struggling with this press defense. Stewart is able to get it to Allen. Again, Allen a key cog in this Lady Dons offense. She's the one that is distributing the ball for us. That one's going to be off the rim and off the top of the backboard. A missed opportunity there by the Dons. Again, the score is 6-2 here in the first quarter. 6 minutes left here in this one, in the first quarter. Again, that is Swalger with the ball for the Flyers. She kicks it to a low. 3-point shot, and it is off the rim. The Dons are able to score there, brings the deficit down to 4-6. A hook shot there by Tapasa that ends up going a little long, but it will stay here with the Flyers. That is number 3, Jocelyn Brady, who will be inbounding here on this one. Ball is inbounded and brought into Anid Vaifuna. Kicked into the middle in the paint. Nice little jumper, but it is off, and there's going to be a scrum for the ball there at the bottom. And there's going to be a jump ball. Possession arrow goes to Spanish Fork. And once again, they are really struggling with the press defense of the Flyers, but a lucky break there as Stewart gets fouled. Foul was on by Fanua. Stewart tries to get it over to Bowman and is unable to do so. Another turnover there by the Dons. Again, this stifling Flyers defense has really put a damper on the Lady Dons offense thus far. The score is 6-4 here. Dixie with the 2-point advantage. About 4:50 left here in the first quarter. A 3-pointer that is off the backboard. The bank is in fact open, ladies and gentlemen. That one is shot by Jocelyn Bundy, who is the leading scorer for the Flyers at just around 10 points a game. It's a nice bit of defense there by Vaifanua, able to poke the ball away, but it will stay here on this side for the Lady Dons. Bowman to inbound this one. Kicks it over to the corner, three-pointer, and it is in! A beautiful shot by Gentry Rosema. Beautiful form from the corner and a nice read there by Bowman to get it to her. Score is now 9-7, still a two-point advantage for the Flyers. Post pass, nice move, and off the backboard. Yacina Tapasa, that's 6 points for her in this one. And she's been the focal point for the Flyers offense. Bowman with the ball in the corner. Gets it up top, three-point shot. And that is gonna be off the rim and off the backboard. A nice little hustle there by Bowman to try to recover that one. Unfortunately, not able to get to it in time. It'll be the Flyers ball here with 3:59 left in the first quarter. Score is 11-7, 4-point advantage for the Flyers. It's Jocelyn Bundy with the ball for the Flyers. Kicked it to Vaifanua. Back up top to Bundy. Kicking it back out. A nice drive. Floater off the rim, but rebounded nicely by Tapasa, who puts it back up. 8 points already for the center for the Flyers. That's Bowman with the ball for the Lady Dons. Again, the score now 13-7. 6-point lead for Dixie. Over to the corner. Oh, a nice look. Nice read. Stewart unable to finish, but a good rebound by Rosema gives them another possession, and she is fouled. She'll be going to the free throw line for a couple of free throws here on that second effort opportunity.
Roseman the line, shooting two for the Lady Dogs.
As she prepares for this first one, it really has been a crazy up and down game here thus far. As she misses that first one, you see that the Dons just haven't quite been able to settle into their offense because of the press defense of the Flyers really giving them trouble. Because when they have been able to actually get themselves set up here in the half court, they've been able to find some good quality shots. As that one goes in, a 1-for-2 free throw trip there for Rosema. 4 points for her in this one so far. Nice entry pass that then gets kicked out. They go right back to their leading scorer in this one, Tapasa. That one is off the back of the rim and controlled by the Dons. A beautiful spin move, and it goes in. A nice feed there by Allen into Haley Cardoza, who gets her first 2 points of the game. 13-10 now, 3-point lead for Dixie as they have the ball. The Swaldry with it, and it gets poked away, and that is a good turnover there for the Dons. Allen sends it up court. They're going to kick it back out to the three-point line. That is going to be airballed there by Rosema. Rebounded by Schwalger. Three-point shot for the Flyers. That one off the back of the rim. And rebounded by Bowman. Bowman gets it to Allen. A nice entry pass. And that is going to be a foul. A good opportunity here for Haley Cardoza at the line. And also a nice read there by Allen to get that pass in and be able to force that foul and give Cardoza the opportunity here to make a couple free throws. The first one is unfortunately bouncing around a bit on the rim, and it is out. 2:15 left here in the first quarter. The score is 13-10. The Flyers over the Lady Dons. As Cardoza goes for her second free throw. This one goes in. 50% so far from the line are the Lady Dons. That is 3 points so far in the game for Cardoza. Schwager kicks it to Vaifanua. Addison Schaefer with the ball now for the Flyers. Oh, nice thought there on defense. A put-up shot there by Vaifanua, but it is off the rim. That is going to be a foul on the floor. Loose ball foul
on the Flyers.
That was their fourth team foul. And once again, that press defense really giving the Lady Down some trouble. And once again, getting bailed out there on the foul. The press break just has not been quite as sharp as you would hope for the Lady Dons, but they have been able to recover nicely. They've been able to cause a couple turnovers of their own and have been shooting pretty well once they have been able to get themselves in their half-court set. That is inbounded to Rosema. Gets it into Bowman. Another nice look right at the rim for Cardoza, and she is able to convert and get the and one opportunity. 5 points so far for Haley Cardoza, and an opportunity to get her sixth one here at the line and potentially put the Lady Dons in front. And she does so. A nice job by Haley Cardoza. Gets the and one play, 6 points in the game, and the Lady Dons take the lead here, 14-13. My apologies. They tie it up 13-13. Again, math is hard, ladies and gentlemen. Again, we only have a bit of time here. Really, the Dixie Flyers don't necessarily have one go-to player that they've used this season. It's really been a combination of most of their starters. They average around 8 to 9 points each. There's a nice deflection there, but it is recovered by the Flyers. 3-point shot is off, but a nice desperation opportunity there by the Flyers, but it is recovered by the Dons. Entry pass into Stewart, who gets fouled. Nice job there by Stewart to get herself in position, get a shot up, and gets fouled on that one. Foul is on Finlinson. There'll be two shots here for Taylor Stewart. That one is off the rim. And just when I was saying math was hard, I was right. I was right. It is 14-13. So 1 point advantage here for the Lady Dons on the second free throw there by Stewart. It is also off. So an 0-for-2 trip there for the center. The ball is controlled now by Dixie. They get it to Swalger. Swalger kicks it back to Bundy. He kicks it to Schaefer, who finds an open Ta'alili. But unfortunately, she was not able to control that one. A costly turnover there for the Dixie Flyers now with 45 seconds left here in the first quarter. Bowman with it, kicks it to Allen. And there is a wide open Haley Cardoza. A beautiful press break there by the Dons. And it extends their lead now 16-13 with 25 seconds left here in the first quarter. Post entry, kicks it back out. A shot fake, gets it back to Schwalter. 15 seconds left here in the first quarter. Dixie trying to do what they can to cut into this deficit. That is going to be off the rim. And it is going to be Don's ball. A nice job there on the potential rebound opportunity to keep it away from the Flyers. 5 seconds left here. We'll see if the Dons are able to get a shot off. Stewart hucks it up. It is off the backboard and controlled by the Flyers. So even though they struggled with the press of the Flyers, it is the Lady Dons who are able to go into the second quarter with an advantage here. The score is 16-13, a 3-point lead for the Spanish Park Lady Dons over the Dixie Flyers.
Hi, welcome to Two Jacks Pizza.
For the best pizza you'll ever taste and our world-famous cheese sticks, come to Two Jacks Pizza on Main Street in Spanish Fork or call us for a quick delivery. Are you hungry yet? MVP Sports is the number one source for sporting goods in Spanish Fork. Football, soccer, all the fall sports, we've got you covered. Check out our new custom t-shirt builder. Design at home and we'll build it for you. MVP Sports, 72 North Main in Spanish Fork.
The best time to check your furnace is before it fails, and you can rely on Triple T to do the job right. Our technicians are trained every year so you can sleep better at night, knowing your furnace is safe to operate. Call Triple T at 798-7711 to schedule your tune-up today.
Need a new car or truck? The Car Guys has the best selection of used vehicles at the best prices in Spanish Fork. The Car Guys know their automobiles to get you the best car for your needs and your budget. The Car Guys at 872 North Main in Spanish Fork.
To Spanish Fork 17 for the second quarter of this first round playoff game. It is the Spanish Fork Dons against the Dixie Flyers. The Lady Dons with a 3-point advantage so far in this one. The score is 16-13. The Dons have been very impressive in this one so far when they've been able to get into their half-court sets, and they've also done a good job in the last couple of possessions to be able to break the press defense of the Flyers. It really gave the Lady Dons quite the headache at the beginning of this one, but looks like they've found a way to maybe calm that down as we begin here the second quarter. It is the Flyers with the ball. That is going to be a double dribble on the Flyers. An unfortunate break for them. Bowman to inbound it for the Lady Dons. Gets it into Allen. Again, the Flyers are really doing good of getting traps here on their press. A long mid-range shot by Taylor Stewart, and it goes in. A great shot there by the center. Gets herself on the board with those 2 points. Score is now 18-13. Mid-range jumper off the back of the rim and controlled briefly by the Dons, and that is going to be a jump ball as Stewart is on the floor and was caught in a scrum there underneath the bucket. Again, the Dons coming into this one as a 2 seed from their region. That is why we have the home game here in Spanish Fork. Nice outlet pass, mid-range jumper, and it is in. Buried by Erica Allen. 4 points for the point guard. Score is 20-13. That was a nice move there by Tapasa. But it is off. And they are going to call a loose ball foul on the Flyers. It will send Gentry Rosema to the line.
Gentry Rosema shooting 1-1 for the Lady Dons.
It's a 1-1 opportunity for her. It's going to be off the backboard, but they are going to call a lane violation on that one on the Flyers, as it was Alo who was bodying up before the shot even began. That one is off and rebounded by Alo. Brought into Bundy. Bundy is going to take the 3-point shot and swish it. Nice job there by Bundy to recognize the soft coverage there on defense and go ahead and puts it up. And there's going to be a timeout here, and that is going to be a great opportunity for us to talk about our wonderful sponsors as the Blue Diamond Auto Group, Prime Mortgage Lending, Triple T Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing, Mikkel Thompson Wise, Attorneys at Law, State Farm, Lance Wilson, MVP Sports, and Two Jacks Pizza. Again, this has been such a fun environment, and it's always, always fun to be part of playoff basketball here on Spanish Fork 17. Again, this Lady Dons team was very impressive this season. As I said, we're able to finish second in their region. Overall, they were 16-4 on the season and 9-3 in region play, so certainly they've had a really fantastic season. Again, most of that has run through Stewart and Bowman, and so you expect to see more of them as this game goes on, and there is a foul once again on the Flyers. And that is going to put Stewart on the line, as the Flyers are already, as you saw from our last free throw attempts here, they are already in the bonus at this point.
Taylor Stewart on the line, shooting 1-1.
Stewart with the first of the 1-1. And she's able to sink it, so she will get the opportunity to shoot a second free throw here. Score is now 21-16, 5-point lead for the Lady Dons. This one is also in, a perfect free throw trip for Stewart, 4 points for her. Score is now 22-16. Entry pass, mid-range shot, beautiful form there by Sina Tapasa, who is now in double digits for the game. 10 points for her. Allen with the mid-range off the backboard and off the rim, but rebounded nicely and put back up by Allen. A nice job there by Cardoza to get the offensive board, kick it back to her point guard, and she gets the easy layup. And off the back of the backboard there. An unfortunate shot there for the Flyers, and it is grabbed by the Dons, outletted up. Cardoza able to make the defense blow by. Nice little pump fake, and it is up. Cardoza now in double digits, 10 for her. Score is now 26-18. 8-point lead for the Lady Dons. Mid-range jumper in. Sina Tapasa has been everything for the Flyers. 12 points for her. Allen into Cardoza, kicks it back to Allen. Stewart up top. Mid-range jumper off the backboard and rebounded by Bundy. Bundy pushing it up, goes to the corner. Nice little jumper there by Schwager. That is off. And that is going to stay down here. It is off the Dons. Fast and furious pace here to start off the second quarter. The score is 26-20, 6-point lead here for the Lady Dons in this first round matchup here in the playoffs. Tries to get it into Tapasa, does so, and she gets the and one, finishes strong. Tapasa with 14 of the Flyers' 22 points. She has been huge for them down low, but also showing her shooter's touch as well, as that is a made free throw, giving her 15 points on the game and cutting into this Dons lead. The score now 26-23. Stewart with it to the corner. Bowman works it up and in. A beautiful floater by Eliza Bowman. Again, Bowman, the leading scorer for the Dons, has been mostly quiet in this one. That is going to be off the foot of the Dons. Flyers with the ball again. Bundy with it. Bundy to Schwager. To the corner. Oh, and a nice drive, but left just short there was Vaifanoa. And the Dons are pushing it up once again. Cardoza with it. Up and in and one. A nice job by Haley Cardoza to catch that pass, bring it down, get herself collected enough to take the shot, puts it up, and is now on the free throw line for that good old traditional three-point play. Score is now 30-23, 7-point lead for the Lady Dons. Ben Cardoza going toe-to-toe here with Tapasa thus far in this one, as that is going to be off the rim and rebounded nicely by the Flyers. 12 points for Cardoza, 15 for Tapasa. This has been a fun first-round matchup so far. Three-point shot is a little bit off there. That is going to be out of bounds. The Dons with possession here. As you see, the Flyers have now backed up their full-court press. Probably a blessing here for the Dons. Allen kicks it to Rosma. Bowman, corner, drive, up and left a little long. Cardoza tried to put it back up, but it is recovered by the Flyers. Trying to get it to the corner. Oh, and it's going to be a foul. So they're going to call that one on Bowman.
Fouls on Bowman. 13 foul on the Lady Dons.
It's the 13 foul for the Lady Dons, so certainly not in the kind of foul trouble that the Flyers are. Again, the score here is 30-23. 3:55 left here in the first half. Been an impressive showing for the Lady Dons when they've been able to get themselves set up in the half court. Found a lot of easy buckets down low to Cardoza. Nice floater off the backboard. Scrum at the bottom. And is recovered by the Flyers. They go to the corner. That is Bundy for three. In and out. Another three. This one swished. A nice job by Sina Schwalger. That's exactly the kind of opportunity that the Flyers are going to need to get back in this one. 30-26. And that is going to be Flyers ball. They caused the turnover there. A good trap. Schwalger with the ball for the Flyers. 3:15 left here in the first half. Kicks it to the corner to Bundy. Over to Vaifanoa, who kicks it back to Schwalger. Nice 2-3 zone here by the Dons, and it works to perfection as they're able to get the turnover. Allen with the ball for the Dons. In the corner is Stewart, goes for the three, and it is off the front of the rim. And rebounded by Vaifanoa. Goes up for the layup there and is fouled. Foul's going to be on Allen. And as you can hear, the home fans are none too pleased with that particular call. It'll be free throws here for Vaifanoa. First one is off. Back in the game for the Flyers is Tapasa, who has a game-high 15 in this one. That one is buried there by Vaifanoa. Dons with the ball here, score 30-27, 3-point lead. Oh, a nice job by Taylor Stewart to find the open Cardoza, who is unable to finish on that layup. They kick it to the corner. It is Tapasa with the ball down low, and there is going to be a foul. As Allen is beside herself, as the foul is going to go on her. And the refs just called a warning on the Spanish Fork bench. Things are getting a little too hostile for his taste. Don't blame him. This last little couple of possessions has been a little chippy. Refs are discussing things, making sure everything gets all set up. Going to be Flyers ball once we get back to the action here. It'll be Vaifanoa that will inbound it for the Flyers. She gets it into Tapasa. Over to Schaffer. Oh, a nice entry pass and in. Who else is going to score but Sina Tapasa for the Dixie Flyers? 17 points already in the game for her. Outside shot off the front of the rim, rebounded by Cardoza, who gets it to Allen, who then kicks it to Rosma. Three-point shot off the rim for the Lady Dons. Flyers pushing it up. Back to Schaffer. He gets it to Tapasa. Mid-range jumper. It is in. Sina Tapasa has been absolutely automatic in this game. 19 points for her. As the Flyers retake the lead here, it is 31-30. And that is going to be called a charge. The Flyers bench going absolutely insane on that one as Tapasa draws the offensive charge there. A As it feels for a little bit here that the momentum of this game is now going towards the Flyers of Dixie. Looks like there's a bit of a miscommunication here with the subs. Yeah, as you can see, the coach there is just like, I don't know what's going on here. Felt like they were saying that when Bowman came back in that it was not done properly, but it seemed like it was done properly to me. Again, score 31-30 here, 1:30 left here in the first half. Flyers with a one-point lead here in this first round of the state tournament, stolen by Erica Allen. Good possession here, hopefully, for the Dons. Bowman back to Stewart. Stewart with the drive and is blocked, but gets the foul call. Does not get the foul call, gets the jump ball call. Sina Tapasa is making her presence known in this game. 19 points, and on these past two possessions has been absolutely huge on defense for the Flyers. And that is going to be off the rim. It was Schaffer who shot that mid-range jumper for the Flyers. There's going to be a foul on the floor. Some free throws coming up here for the Lady Dons. Foul is on McAllister. And Ms. Rosemont on the line for the Lady Dons. And that one is in. Gentry Rosemont calmly knocks down the first of her two free throws. 5 points in the game for her. As this thing is all knotted up now at 31 with 1:05 left in the first half. Rosma's second one is a bit too strong and off the back of the rim. Oh, a nice defensive play by Eliza Bowman. Gets the steal and another possession here for the Dons. 31-31 with 53 seconds left in the first half. Bowman with it in the corner. She kicks it to Stewart, kicks it back to Allen, to Cardoza, back to Allen. Allen over to the corner. Cardoza with it again. In the corner is Bowman. Oh, a wide open look there for Allen. Instead, she drives and puts it up. Beautiful drive there by Erica Allen. I thought she was going to spot up from three. Instead, she does a little bit of Euro stepping and gives the Lady Dons the lead here. 3-point shot up and way strong there by the Flyers. That is going to be a foul. That was Mel Alla with the shot there. Foul is on Cardoza. The 16th foul for the Lady Dons. And 18 seconds left here in the first half. That is going to be off the front of the rim by Mel Allo. And the story of this half really for the Dixie Flyers has been Sina Tapasa. 19 points and a huge presence on defense for them as Allo hits the second of her free throws. Goes 1-for-2 on that trip. 18.8 seconds left here in the first half of this one. The Dons with a one-point lead, 33-32. And there's going to be a foul. Seems lately that whenever the Flyers have been putting on the press defense, they've been fouling the Dons and really bailing them out in some ways. This is Taylor Stewart back on the line for the Dons. Hits every part of the rim, but unfortunately does not fall in there for Stewart. Again, the score 33-32. Stewart with the opportunity to give them a two-point lead here on this free throw. And she does so. 5 points for Taylor Stewart. And 16 seconds left here in this one. Swager with the ball. Kicks it to Schaffer. Schaffer to Bundy. Back over to Schaffer. And they're going to have to put up a desperation shot here. And it is going to be off. Bundy with the final heave there at the half. But it is unsuccessful as the Lady Dons able to... There's a run there by the Flyers. But they were able to stave it off as the Lady Dons keep control of this one. The score is 34-32 as we head into the second half. Thank you so much for being with us, and we will give you the second half of action when we come back here on Spanish Fork 17.
I definitely recommend the Driggs team. They're amazing.
Hi, my name is Greg Driggs. I'm the local manager for Prime Mortgage Lending, where our motto is, find a path to yes. Stop by our office today on Main Street and let us help you get into your brand new home.
That was the dance team, and we will get you back with more coverage of this game later on Spanish 417.
Hi, welcome to Two Jacks Pizza.
For the best pizza you'll ever taste and our world-famous cheese sticks, come to Two Jacks Pizza on Main Street in Spanish Fork or call us for a quick delivery. Are you hungry yet?
MVP Sports is the number one source for sporting goods in Spanish Fork. Football, soccer, all the fall sports, we've got you covered. Check out our new custom t-shirt builder. Design at home and we'll build it for you. MVP Sports, 72 North Main in Spanish Fork.
I definitely recommend the Driggs team. They're amazing.
Hi, my name is Greg Driggs. I'm the local manager for Prime Mortgage Lending, where our motto is, find a path to yes. Stop by our office today on Main Street and let us help you get into your brand new home.
The best time to check your furnace is before it fails, and you can rely on Triple T to do the job right. Our technicians are trained every year so you can sleep better at night, knowing your furnace is safe to operate. Call Triple T at 798-7711 to schedule your tune-up today.
Need a new car or truck? The Car Guys has the best selection of used vehicles at the best prices in Spanish Fork. The Car Guys know their automobiles to get you the best car for your needs and your budget. The Car Guys at 872 North Main in Spanish Fork.
Wild Mustangs. They're supposed to be one of the most gentle creatures in nature.
State Farm knows that for every one of those moments, there's one of these.
Mustangs.
That's why more people save money by combining their home and auto with State Farm.
Call State Farm agent Lance Wilson today.
Nobody plans on getting in an accident, but if it does happen, you can rely on the expertise of Mike McKell to protect and fight for your rights. Specializing in personal injury law, Mike McKell is the attorney you need. contact Mike at Mikkel, Christiansen, and Wise.
Welcome back to Spanish Fork 17 and our coverage of this awesome first round playoff game here for the 4A Girls Basketball Tournament. It is the Spanish Fork Dons against the Dixie Flyers. We are currently in halftime of this one. Just want to go over some of the key things that have happened so far in this one for the Dixie Flyers. Really, everything has run through their forward, Sina Tapasa. She has 19 points in this one. She has been an absolute force down low, but also has been deadly from the mid-range game. Tons of just beautiful jumpers right around the painted area, and was huge on a couple of defensive possessions. Had two straight possessions where she caused an offensive charge and then caused a jump ball that was able to really help the Flyers be able to come back into this one. For the Lady Dons, it's really been a little more of a balanced attack, but a lot of it has run through their center, Haley Cardoza. Cardoza doing a great job of receiving entry passes and really just putting up beautiful layups. She's had a couple of and-one opportunities. She has 12 points in this one. Erica Allen with 8, the point guard for the Lady Dons, and some contributions from Taylor Stewart, Gentry Rosna, and Eliza Bowman as well. Honestly, for this one, I expect to see a little bit more of Eliza Bowman here in the second half. She has been the leading scorer for the Lady Dons all season long, averages about 17 points a game, so a little shocking to see Bowman so quiet so far in this one. So you wonder if there's going to be opportunity for her to be able to kind of get going and to be a bigger part of this Lady Dons offense. For the Flyers, it's interesting because when you read the scouting report for them as part of the rest of the season that we saw, really it seemed like more of a balanced attack. You had several players that were averaging around 9 points, 8 points a game, but really, as I've said, the story for them really has been Sina Tapasa. And so for the Lady Dons, it's figuring out how to really play better defense on her, how to be able to cut her off down low, how to be able to double team her and force her, basically force someone else on the Flyers to shoot the ball. Because whenever it's been into Tapasa, she's been super effective. I think she's maybe only missed two or three shots in this game. So the Lady Dons have really got to do anything and everything that they can to stop her from being the one that could potentially beat them in this one. Again, the winner of this game is going to have the opportunity to head over to Cedar City for the rest of this tournament. They'll be playing on the beautiful campus of Southern Utah. And who doesn't want that opportunity? Cedar City right now probably is a little bit warmer than it is over here in the valley. So that's got to be a big bonus for them. But the winner of this one will be playing the winner of Ridgeline versus Juan Diego. Now, the Lady Dons have actually already played Juan Diego this year and won that game. And so you got to think that that's potentially a matchup that they would like to see in the second round. Again, you'll be able to see that game here on Spanish Fork SCN, Channel 17, of course, here on the cable. But if you want to check that one out online, you'll need to go to KSL and check out Deseret Digital to be able to get access to that particular game. But they are not the only team that we have that is in the playoffs, as the Maple Mountain Boys are also in their playoffs as well. They will be playing the Jordan Beat Diggers. That is going to be on the campus of Weber State University up in Ogden. We are very excited to bring you that game. That game will be on Tuesday, February 26th at 5:50 p.m. And you'll be able to, of course, check that out here on Channel 17. But you will need to be able, if you want to watch that one online, you'll need to go again to KSL and check out Deseret Digital for that particular game. Man, that was an exciting last couple games there for the Golden Eagles, as they were able to force a tiebreaker game with the Provo Bulldogs after beating them the last game of the regular season. And then they played an absolute classic of a game, triple overtime, and eventually were able to win that one. Just an incredible shot at the end of second overtime by Owen Blakey, a deep three-pointer that kept that game alive. And so I'm just as excited as you to see how Maple Mountain does in their playoff bracket as well. But man, we've got a fun one here tonight with Dixie, because they really punch for punch have been right there with the Lady Dons this entire game. Their press defense at the very beginning was absolutely stifling. The Lady Dons just did not quite know what to do with it. Eventually found their groove, and as I said, really kind of ran the offense a lot through Haley Cardoza. And so we'll see what we have on tap here for the second half of this game, as it looks like the players are now on the court and we are getting ready to get all squared away here for the second half of this one. The score is 34-32. It's a two-point lead here for the Lady Dons, and we are underway here for the second half. As Allen kicks that to Rosma, into Taylor Stewart, mid-range, off the back iron, rebounded by Tapasa. Schwalger with the ball for the Flyers. In the corner is Bundy, and it is in. A beautiful three-point shot by Jocelyn Bundy. 9 points on the game for the Flyer guard. 35-34 now. Off the front iron there is Allen. Rebounded by Alo, who tries to turn it up. Tries to get it in there to Schwalger, but it is stolen by Rosma. Up the court. And that is going to be a foul on the floor. There is a scuffle for the ball as they were trying to go for the deep outlet pass there to Bowman. Allen to inbound it. That is into Stewart. In the corner is Allen. Kicks it back. Rosma for three. Off the front iron. Rebounded by Bowman. Up and in. Eliza Bowman making her presence felt here early in the second half. And again, she will need to be an important part of this offense probably going forward, because they're able to force a turnover there, a travel by the Flyers. Once again, the Flyers getting themselves set up for a full court press. And it looks like the Dons really have done a good job of identifying what they need to do to defend themselves against that full court press. Stewart inside, throws up a shot, but it is blocked. It will stay down here for the Lady Dons. Again, score 36-35, 1 point lead for them. Wide open is Taylor Stewart, and Taylor off the backboard. It looks like the bank is still open. There was an earlier bank shot, and this one just proves that, hey, you know, you got to get that money, though. Got to get that money. So 38-35. Oh, a nice drive by Tapasa. Who else for the Dixie Flyers? 21 points for her. 38-37, 1 point lead for the Lady Dons. Bowman with the ball into Stewart at the elbow. Back over to Bowman. Bowman with the drive. Floats it off the rim. That is recovered by Finlinson, but then a costly turnover for the Flyers. Floater and fouled on the shot. Erica Allen puts it up and gets fouled. It's going to be two shots there for the point guard for the Lady Dons. So that one toilet bowls its way out.
Erica Allen, the line shooting for the Lady Dons.
But does have an opportunity to get the second one here. And this one is in. One for two trip there at the free throw line for Erica Allen. She's got 9 points in this one. That is by Fanoa, who had the ball there for the Flyers. She gets it back, keeps it to Schwalger up top. Oh, nice bit of defense there by Eliza Bowman, but it looks like they are going to whistle her for the foul on that one.
Foul's on Bowman.
It's unfortunate, because before the foul, it really was a nice piece of on-ball defense there. Inbounded into Schwalger. Schwalger gets it into Tapasa. Tapasa drives on Stewart and loses handles on it. That is recovered by Cardoza. Dons on the attack. A nice feed by Allen into Cardoza. 14 points for the center. Nice job there by Allen to read the defense there. Gets it into Cardoza, the reliable interior scorer. Oh, a nice feed by the Flyers. Right back with a beautiful post feed. And the finish there by Schwalger, who now has 5 points for the Flyers. 41-38, mid-range jumper. That is left short there by Rosma. Flyers with it. And they kick it to Vaifanoa. comes back out with it into Tapasa at the elbow. McAllister with it up top. By Fanoa off the screen by Tapasa. Gets it into Schwalger. Tries to outlet it over to the corner, over to Bundy. It is knocked out by Rosma. Flyers with the ball still. Timeout here. Fixing some shoelaces. Wouldn't want to be tripping on those. I've done it before. It hurts. It's not fun. Again, the score here, 41-39. A two-point lead for the Lady Dons with 4:28 left here in the third quarter. Nice back-and-forth game here in this first round of the 4A Utah State Girls Basketball Tournament. Tapasa up top. A nice feed in there to Vifanoa, but a little too hot.
Oh, wow. What a move by Sina Schwalger. Euro steps her way right to the rim. 7 points for her in this one. Over to the corner. Now there's a three-point ball off the front of the rim, but rebounded by Stewart. Stewart puts it back up and is fouled. Goes up strong against Tapasa and draws the foul on her. Nice job by Stewart there to just go ahead and go up strong. Fought right towards it, gets the shot off, and gets herself a trip to the free throw line.
Taylor Stewart at line shooting
41-41 in this one. 3:58 left here in the third quarter. Stewart with an opportunity here to give the Lady Dons the lead back. And this one is in. 6 points for Stewart. Again, both of these teams finished over 500 and really were quite impressive in their region play. You can definitely tell the skill level on both teams. As that one is sunk by Stewart. She goes 2 for 2 on that trip. Again, Dixie was the 3 seed out of Region 10. Again, they are fighting for their lives here. Single elimination here in state. That one's put up, but it is a foul. So it'll be Vifanoa going to the line for the Flyers.
Foul's on Erica Allen.
Foul is on Erica Allen. Second team foul of the half here for the Lady Dons as Vifanoa sinks that first one. Vifanoa mostly quiet in this one. That was only her second point of the game. And she sinks the second one. Goes perfect on that trip. Again, really, the Lady Dons have really figured out their press break offense. But as I say that, they turn the ball over. It's Bundy with it for the Flyers. Bundy to Schaffer, who then kicked it to McAllister. And that was Ta'ulili. Bundy to Schaffer with the mid-range jumper.
Schaffer
with her first 2 points of the game. Gives Dixie the lead here, 45-43. Allen with it back over to Bowman. Bowman will get it into Stewart. Stewart immediately double-teamed there. Outside shot by Bowman off the front iron. And that is going to be a fast-break opportunity here for the Flyers. Euro step up. Oh, and they are going to call a blocking foul. Not what the fans here in Spanish Fork wanted to hear. They were really hoping that that one was going to be a charge. Instead, that foul goes the Flyers' way. And it will be free throws Schaefer here for Schaefer. Schaefer connects on the first one. That's her third point of the game. Score now 45-43 to 46-43. 3-point advantage for the Dixie Flyers. And Schaefer now goes up for her second attempt. And this one is also in. 4 points for Addison Schaefer.
Lady Dons get that into Stewart, who then kicks it back over to Bowman. Bowman to Iketau. Stewart loses handle of the ball there, and she's going to call a timeout. Probably a good move there so that the Lady Dons are able to maintain possession there. The score is 47-43 as we go into this timeout. This is a great opportunity for us to tell you about our wonderful sponsors. That is the Blue Diamond Auto Group, Prime Mortgage Lending, Triple T Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing, Mikkel Thompson Wise, Attorneys at Law, State Farm, Lance Wilson, MVP Sports, and Two Jacks Pizza. And as we go into this timeout for the Lady Dons, it's what do we need to do on defense to stop this little run here by the Dixie Flyers, as they've been able to take a four-point lead here in the third quarter. It's just trying to figure out how to stop that offense. And then really for the Lady Dons as well on offense, it's kind of getting things calmed down a little bit. They were able to get an easy bucket by Cardoza earlier in the third quarter here. You'd like to see a little bit more of that. You'd like to see Bowman being a little more aggressive with her cuts, being able to get herself to the rim, and really just kind of making the Flyers defense uncomfortable, just using movement, using screens. That's kind of what you'd like to see from the Lady Dons here as they head back out of here, out of the timeout. And that will be Rosma to inbound it for the Lady Dons. She gets it into Bowman. 2:22 left here in the third quarter. Score is 47-43. Four-point lead for the Dixie Flyers over the Spanish Fork Lady Dons. That is into Stewart. Stewart leaves it just a bit short, and it is rebounded by Bundy. Nice offensive set here so far for the Flyers, keeping it up top and around the perimeter. It's Bundy with the ball. Nice on-ball defense there by Bowman. Almost caused the turnover. Oh, wow, what a move there by Vaifanoa, but left it just a bit off, but they are able to get the offensive rebound, and the corner three is off, but another offensive rebound, this one by Bundy. Two free possessions here for the Flyers. 1:25 left here in the third quarter. Three ball is off the rim and rebounded nicely there by Rosma as the Dons get the ball back. Bowman with it into Stewart, who is immediately just trapped right into the teeth of that Flyers defense, but she is fouled. Substitution there for the Flyers. And it was inbounded into Stewart. Oh, a nice entry feed there. Tried to get it to Bowman. Bowman puts it up and is left short. Cardoza with a follow through that didn't work. There is a foul on the floor. And it is going to be Don's ball. But before that, it looks like there is a timeout. Another opportunity for them to discuss what they want to do on this next offensive possession. But it's also an opportunity for us to be able to once again talk about our wonderful sponsors, the Blue Diamond Auto Group, Prime Mortgage Lending, Triple T Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing, Mikkel Thompson Wise, Attorneys at Law, State Farm Lance Wilson, MVP Sports, and Two Jacks Pizza. I would not mind if somebody brought up some barbecue chicken cheese sticks up here. I would not mind it at all if somebody wanted to do that. But again, heading with this timeout again, it's for the Lady Dons. It's just figuring out what they need to do here to stop this little mini run here by the Flyers. It is the Flyers with the ball here. Score is 47-43 with 1 minute left here in the third quarter. 4 point advantage for the Flyers. Vaifanoa with the ball for them. She gets it to Schwager. Back over to Schaefer. Schwager with it up top. Looks like they are going to be pretty methodical on this particular possession. Oh, nice hands there by Stewart. But it is going to be out on her. 41 seconds left here in the third quarter.
inbounded to Schwalger. Schaefer with it. Although kicks it back.
Oh, and a nice blow by there by Vaifanoa.
And there's going to be a loose ball foul on the Flyers. I think that one is on Taulili. Seconds left here in the third quarter.
A little bit of miscommunication on who was inbounding it. Bowman comes in.
That's going to be tipped out by Schaefer. 25 seconds left now. Bowman to inbound into Rosma. Bowman flings it, gets it.
Oh, and there is a turnover.
Unable to really hang on to that one was Iketau. A nice drive up with the right hand and fouled. Vaifanoa with the strong drive and gets herself to the free throw line. Foul was on Eliza Bowman. It's the fourth team foul of the half for the Lady Dons. The Flyers sit at five fouls in this half. As Vaifanoa is able to can that first free throw. 4 points for her in this one. Extends the Flyers' lead to 5 points. And she nails the second one. 5 points for her. 10 seconds left here in the third quarter. A six-point deficit for the Lady Dons. 5 seconds. Puts up a shot. Stewart left strong, but rebounded nicely. Oh, the left off the front iron there was Bowman. Able to get the offensive board and have an opportunity for a putback, but left just a bit short as the Dixie Flyers really came out flying in this particular third quarter and retake the lead. The score is 49-43 as we head into the fourth quarter, and we will give you the fourth quarter of action in this one when we come back on Spanish Fork 17.
Hi, welcome to Two Jacks Pizza.
For the best pizza you'll ever taste and our world-famous cheese sticks, come to Two Jacks Pizza on Main Street in Spanish Fork or call us for a quick delivery. Are you hungry yet? MVP Sports is the number one source for sporting goods in Spanish Fork. Football, soccer, all the fall sports, we've got you covered. Check out our new custom t-shirt builder. Design at home and we'll build it for you. MVP Sports, 72 North Main in Spanish Fork.
The best time to check your furnace is before it fails, and you can rely on Triple T to do the job right. Our technicians are trained every year so you can sleep better at night, knowing your furnace is safe to operate. Call Triple T at 798-7711 to schedule your tune-up today.
Need a new car?
Welcome back to Spanish Fork 17 and the fourth quarter of action here in Spanish Fork. It is the Spanish Fork Lady Dons against the Dixie Flyers in the first round of the state playoffs here.
Oh, a beautiful turnover. Oh, just to get it right back and get it right back. Oh,
crazy little sequence there, but the Dons are able to maintain that particular turnover. Allen kicks it to Schaefer, gets it back to Allen. In the corner is Bowman, drives and is able to draw the foul onto Pasa. Nice job there by Bowman to draw contact and get herself to the free throw line. Again, Bowman, the leading scorer this season for the Lady Dons, and has had a relatively quiet 4 points in this game. There have been others that have picked up the slack, such as Cardoza. As that one is in, 5 points for Eliza Bowman. Cuts this lead down to five. The score is 49-44. Bowman getting ready for her second free throw. And this one is also in. A perfect free throw trip there for Eliza Bowman. 6 points on the game for her. Now a 4-point lead for the Flyers. So they get into Alo.
And that is swished in. A beautiful mid-range jumper there by Mel Alo. 5 points for her. And it is back up to a 6-point lead for the Flyers.
Allen with it for the Lady Dons. Keeping it around the perimeter, gets it into Cardoza, who goes up and gets fouled. Now we'll put Cardoza on the line for the Lady Dons.
She will get the first of those two. 15 points for Haley Cardoza. Really been a very impressive offensive game for her. Has found good positioning down low and been able to draw plenty of fouls as she hits a lot of the rim, but it does go down. 16 points for the center, for the Lady Dons. Score is now 51-47, a four-point advantage for the Flyers. Alo with it is double-teamed, and it forces the turnover. Nice job by Rosma to get in the passing lane and pick that one off. Good hands there by Bundy. They were looking for the corner and unable to find it. It'll still be the Dons ball here. Bowman to inbound. Gets into Allen, back into Stewart. Stewart trying to find Cardoza down low, but it is picked off. Nice job there on defense for the Flyers. Alo and Vaifanoa with a little two-person game there, but that is a corner three that is airballed but recovered by the Flyers. Oh, and a nice scrum down low. There's going to be
jump ball,
a jump ball there. Possession arrow is with the Lady Dons, so they will take possession, but it looks like Roseman got a little beaten up there on that one, but looks like she's fine. Nice play there by Gentry Rosema to basically give the Lady Dons the possession here. Allen and Stewart work their way up the court to break the press. Allen to Bowman, back into Stewart. Stewart to the corner. That is an open three, and it is in! Beautiful shot by Erica Allen. 12 points in the game for the point guard. Cuts this lead down to one for the Flyers. Nice defense there by Stewart. A good drive by Vaifanoa, left a bit short, but is able to get her own rebound. Long three by Bundy off the back iron and rebounded. Big rebound there by Taylor Stewart. Given back to Erica Allen. Only a one-point lead now for the Flyers with a made basket here. And that's going to be off the back of the rim and going to be out. Lady Dons are just down a point, so their next made basket, if they can get a stop here, would put them back in the lead. They've done a good job of coming back here in the fourth quarter. We're down by six at one point, able to fight themselves back into this one. 5:10 left here in the game. Dixie Flyers with a one-point lead over the Lady Dons here in this first-round playoff game. A drive, a mid-range jumper off the front iron and rebounded by the Lady Dons. Good job there by Cardoza. Allen pushing it up the court. We'll kick it back to Rosema. They throw the pass to the corner. Allen unable to control that one. A costly turnover there for the Dons. As it'll be the Flyers ball here once again. Vaifanoa with it for them. There is going to be a timeout by the Flyers. Going to discuss what they would like to do here on this offensive possession. It's a good time for us to be able to talk about our wonderful sponsors, the Blue Diamond Auto Group, Prime Mortgage Lending, Triple T Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing, McKellen Thompson, Wise Attorneys at Law, State Farm, Lance Wilson, MVP Sports, and Two Jacks Pizza. Obviously for the Flyers, the main thought here is what they can do to kind of get their offense back and settled down, as they've had a couple of turnovers here lately. They would obviously love a good possession here that leads to a quality shot to be able to extend their lead. For the Lady Dons, it's keeping up that pressure on defense. They really have done a great job of getting into the passing lanes and really disrupting this Flyer offense. So if they want to finish the little comeback here that they've had since the beginning of the fourth quarter, that is going to be key. It's really continuing to stifle this Flyer offense and then getting themselves in favorable matchups on offense. Continuing to work through Cardoza, seeing opportunities for Bowman That is what you'd like to see on offense for the Lady Dons as we get back here from the timeout. Flyers with the ball, 4:40 left here in this one. Oh, a big turnover. Good hands there by the Lady Dons. It's Allen with it up top, who kicks it back to Rosma. Obviously looking for a good quality shot here. Cardoza with the floater, but it is rebounded by Eliza Bowman. A nice putback by the leading scorer for the Lady Dons. She puts them back on top in this one. It's 52-51. Tapoza with the shot, and that is one of the few times that Tapasa has missed a shot. On the break is the Dons. Off the back of the iron was Bowman's shot. And now it's a fast break opportunity for the Flyers. And a nice layup there by Sina Schwager. 9 points for her in this one. Point guard for the Flyers. And that is going to be a scrum right there at the half court line. It's a jump ball, and that is going to go to Dixie. A nice job there to trap Allen and force that turnover. 3:41 left in this one. This one looks like it's going to be going right down to the wire, folks. 53-52, a one-point edge here for the Dixie Flyers. As they have the ball here, that is Schwager with it. Kicks it back over to Vaifanoa, who gives it back up to Schwager. Again, keeping it up top, looking for an opportunity to get it in, and there it is to Tapasa. Good defense there by Stewart, but she is called for the foul. A good strong drive there by Sina Tapasa. She's going to get herself to the free throw line. Tapasa has actually been relatively quiet here in the second half. She scored 19 points in the first half, an absolute monster half for her that has only had 2 points thus far, now 3 points here in the second half, as she's now up to 22 and extends that Flyer lead to 2 as well. And that is off the back iron and rebounded by the Lady Dons. That's Rosma on the rebound. Into Stewart. Over in the corner is Bowman. Oh, Bowman somehow sneaks her way in there, puts up a shot, but is off. It is rebounded by Tapasa, who then throws an absolute beauty of an outlet pass up to Schwager. And that is going to extend the lead for the Flyers to 4. Into Cardoza. Cardoza with the right hand. Oh, just off the rim. Looked like it was going to go down. A good, strong move there with the hook shot, but does not fall. 4-point lead here for the Flyers with 2:35 left in this one. That's Schwager with it up top. That is going to be a foul on the floor, but at this point we are... Oh no, it looks like they were setting up as though it was going to be in the bonus, but we are not quite there yet. Flyers with the ball here by Fanoa, and it is stolen by Stewart. Stewart gets it in to Bowman. Bowman with the layup, and it is in. Cuts that lead in half. Bowman, again, kind of quiet in the first half of this one. And there is some discussion with the refs. And looks like they got it all figured out. So the point is still good for Bowman, who now is in double digits with 10. Score is 56-54. 2-point lead for the Dixie Flyers here. And this one to Pasa at the elbow. Kicks it back to Schaefer. Schaefer with the mid-range, and it is off. A good defensive possession there for the Lady Dons. And that is going to be a timeout by the Flyers as they want to discuss things after a missed opportunity there on that offensive possession. We are down to the wire here in this one, folks, 56-54. During this timeout, it's a great opportunity for us to
talk about our lovely and fantastic sponsors, the Blue Diamond Auto Group, Prime Mortgage Lending, Triple T Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing, Mikhail Thompson Wise, Attorneys at Law, State Farm, Lance Wilson, MVP Sports, and Two Jacks Pizza. And as we are going down to the wire in this one, it's just been a fantastic game. Both teams have really played well in spurts in this one. There have been some sloppy moments in this one, as there has been quite a few turnovers, but you can also attribute that to just great defense in this one. Obviously, the Dixie Flyers have a solid full-court press defense that they've utilized several times in this game. For the Lady Dons, they really have a solid 2-3 zone that is their mainstay go-to, and it really has worked many times for them in this one. So, as I said, as this one goes down to the wire, you're probably going to see a lot of Sina Tapasa for the Dixie Flyers, as she has 22 points in this one and has been relatively quiet in the second half. And for the Lady Dons, it's continuing to work through Cardoza and Bowman and Allen. As we get things kicked off again, 2 minutes left in this one. Bowman with the ball for the Lady Dons, kicks it to Allen. Allen into Stewart, and Stewart is fouled.
Taylor Stewart at the line.
Stewart will be at the line on this one. As they are now in the bonus, it will be a one-and-one opportunity for her. If she can sink both of these, it will put the Lady Dons back in a tie with the Flyers here with 1:55 left. And she is able to connect on the first. Big shot by Taylor Stewart. 8 points in the game. 56-55. Lady Dons now only down one. Her second free throw is good. Cold as ice there at the free throw line is Taylor Stewart, as this thing is once again all tied up. Tapasa with the strong move. It is off the rim and rebounded by Stewart. Lady Dons now with an opportunity to take the lead here late in this one. 1:40 left, 56-56. In the corner, Rosema. There is going to be a whistle. That is going to be a timeout. Probably a good timeout there by the Lady Dons, as Rosema was in a trap there and in a bit of trouble. It's an opportunity for us to talk about our next game coming up. It is the Maple Mountain Golden Eagles up against the Jordan Beat Diggers up at Weber State University in Ogden. It's going to be a fantastic game, first round of the playoffs for them. That is going to be Tuesday night. That is Tuesday the 26th. At 5:50 p.m., you don't want to miss that one, as the Golden Eagles had quite the crazy end of the season. And we'll also remind you that the winner of this one will be playing Ridgeline or Juan Diego. That game will be down in beautiful Cedar City, Utah, on the campus of Southern Utah University. That game would be on Thursday, the 28th, at 5:50 p.m., if the Lady Dons are able to come away victorious in this one. We will give you coverage of that one here on Spanish Fork 17. On our cable channel, and you'll be able to check that one out online via KSL and through Deseret Digital. Again, 56-56 here. It is a crazy one that's going right down to the last tick, folks. Bowman to inbound it for the Lady Dons, and she does so, gets it into Stewart, immediately gets the ball back and kicks it to Allen. Allen to Cardoza. Bowman in the corner again. Nice ball movement here by the Lady Dons, hoping to find themselves a nice quality shot to give themselves the lead in the corner. Oh, a long pass there back to Bowman in the other corner. Stewart with it at the elbow. Allen to Cardoza, back into Stewart, to Allen. They are going to milk some clock here, it looks like, trying to find themselves a quality shot. A nice shot fake there by Allen, gets it to Cardoza, the corner. There is Rosema, she kicks it back to Allen. Bowman, and there's gonna be a foul. A huge foul on Sina Tapasa. And that is gonna put Taylor Stewart on the line with the opportunity to take the lead here with 48 seconds left in this game. Another couple of huge free throws here for Stewart. She went 2 for 2 on her last trip to tie this ball game back up. And now she's got the opportunity to give her team the lead and an opportunity to see themselves through this game and on to the next round and on to Cedar City. As she connects on the first one, goes straight up and in through the hoop. Double digits for Taylor Stewart. That is her 10th point of the game. And it gives the Lady Dons the one-point advantage late here in the fourth quarter. Make it two. A nice job by Taylor Stewart. 4 for 4 on her last two trips at the free throw line. The Lady Dons with a two-point advantage late here in the fourth quarter. 40 seconds left in this ball game. And there's going to be a timeout there for Dixie, as they did not like what was happening there at the beginning of that particular offensive possession. They will come together and discuss what it is they need to do to get themselves 2 points and potentially tie this thing back up. And for the Lady Dons, this is all about what they need to do on defense. And honestly, the best thing they could do is double up Sina Tapasa, who has 22 points in this one and has been the focal point of the Flyer defense thus far in this one. So doubling her up and making it so others will have to shoot the ball is going to be key for the Dons to make sure that they can maintain this lead. As the teams now head back onto the court in this one, 58-56, a 2-point lead for the Lady Dons with 38 seconds left in this awesome first round matchup here in the 4A Utah Girls State Basketball Tournament. It has been an absolute blast. That is inbounded to Schwager, who takes the mid-range off the rim. And that is going to stay down here for the Flyers. They say it is off the Lady Dons, off of Erica Allen. 33 seconds left here in this one. Dons just needing to play some solid defense. Another mid-range jumper, and it is in. A beautiful answer there by Sina Schwager. 13 points for her. And the press defense is on, and there is a costly turnover. This thing is all knotted up. Oh, and there is all sorts of craziness happening right there. The ball right there by the ref. Only 16 seconds left in this one. It is all tied up. Dixie with the ball when we come out of this timeout. Just a crazy sequence there. Again, for the Lady Dons, again, this is all about defense. The Flyers will be able to hold and be able to have the last possession here most likely. And so it's just about staying strong on defense, being able to figure out how they can keep the Flyers from any kind of quality shot. For the Flyers, it's going to be probably running this offense through Sina Tapasa again. 22 points in this one and has been a force down low. Really, they've used her at the elbow to facilitate the offense. You've got to expect that that is what you are going to see for these last 16 ticks of the game. All the marbles on the line here with 16 seconds left. This thing all tied up at 58-58. Again, the winner of this one will head on to the second round of these playoffs and will play the winner of Ridgeline or Juan Diego down in Cedar City. And here we go for the last 16 seconds of this game. Inbounding it is Vi Fanoa. She gets it into Schaefer. Back to Vi Fanoa. Gets it at the elbow. And that is going to be an offensive foul. Oh, what a great job there by Taylor Stewart. Beautiful defense causes the turnover. And now the Lady Dons have 9 seconds to get themselves a shot and take home the win here with their home crowd just waiting to explode if they can do so. Bowman into Allen, gets it back to Bowman. Bowman into Rosema. Rosema with the shot. And it is going to be off. And this thing is going to overtime. All knotted up at 58-58. Rosema with a clean look from the mid-range to be able to win this one. Unfortunately, it is off the rim. And we have some extra basketball, folks. We will give you the overtime when we come back on Spanish 417.
Hi, welcome to Two Jacks Pizza.
For the best pizza you'll ever taste and our world-famous cheese sticks, come to Two Jacks Pizza on Main Street in Spanish Fork or call us for a quick delivery. Are you hungry yet? MVP Sports is the number one source for sporting goods in Spanish Fork. Football, soccer, all the fall sports, we've got you covered. Check out our new custom t-shirt builder. Design at home and we'll build it for you. MVP Sports, 72 North Main in Spanish Fork.
The best time to check your furnace is before it fails, and you can rely on Triple T to do the job right. Our technicians are trained every year so you can sleep better at night, knowing your furnace is safe to operate. Call Triple T at 798-7711 to schedule your tune-up today.
Need a new car or truck? The Car Guys has the best selection of used vehicles at the best prices in Spanish Fork. The Car Guys know their automobiles to get you the best car for your needs and your budget. The Car Guys at 872 North Main in Spanish Fork.
Time for some overtime here on Spanish Fork 17. This game was all tied up 58-58. Is the Spanish Fork Lady Dons against the Dixie Flyers. This thing was not ended in regulation. It was Gentry Roseman with a clean look at the end of regulation, but was unable to hit it. And we are in the overtime period. The Lady Dons with the ball here. And it is kicked back to Allen, who gets it into Stewart, who kicks it back out to Rosema, who had a clean look there from three for a second. Defense was able to close in on her. Allen now with it. Back to Rosema. In the corner is Allen for three. It is in! Another big three by Erica Allen. 15 points in the game for Allen, and that is the first blood of overtime. Score is now 61-58, a three-point lead for the Lady Dons. 3:15 left here in overtime. Bifanoa with it for the Flyers. Drives, draws the contact on Stewart. Stewart stands her ground and draws the charge. Oh, huge sequence for the Lady Dons. Getting the opening three and then drawing that charge. Oh, that's exactly what you need coming into overtime on this one. 3 minutes left here in overtime. 3-point lead for the Lady Dons. Roseman with it, kicks it to Allen. Allen over to Cardoza. There's Allen calling the shots here, trying to get her offense set up. Back over to Allen, into Stewart. Back over to Roseman. Looks like they're really looking for an opportunity to play off of Stewart there at the elbow, as they're going to get it into her. Back to Rosema. A little bit of keep away here with the lead, trying to create a quality shot or just hold it and make the Flyer defense come to them. Bowman with it into Stewart. Stewart back to Allen. Again, doing a nice job of really just milking the clock here. Dixie's not going to come up and press and force the issue here. And there's going to be a foul. Really a solid possession there for the Lady Dons. Again, in high school, there is no shot clock, and so you can take as long as you want on a possession, and that is exactly what you need to do here with the lead. It is Allen at the free throw line for the Lady Dons. Plays around with every single part of the rim, and it eventually falls down. 16 points for Erica Allen. With the opportunity to continue to extend this lead, it is 62-58. And she gets the second. 2-for-2 trip for Erica Allen, 17 points on the game. Score now 63-58, a 5-point advantage here in overtime for the Lady Dons. 2 minutes left here in the overtime period. That is Alla with the ball. She gives it to Schaefer. Schaefer in the corner to Vifanoa. Bundy with it. Bundy with the little move. Kicks it to the corner. Open three. Off the rim and rebounded by Taylor Stewart. Oh, a big opportunity there for Schwager to cut into the lead. Instead, it rims out. And now the Lady Dons really in control of this overtime period. Unfortunately, we're called for the foul there. So it is the Flyers' ball once again.
Back into Schaefer, gets it to Hollow. Schwalger with the drive, up with the right, off the backboard and in. Stina Schwalger with 15 in this one. She cuts the lead down to 63-60. There's a timeout. And again, this is an opportunity for us to remind you that we have our next game on Tuesday, February 26th at 5:50 p.m. That is the Maple Mountain Golden Eagles against the Jordan Beat Diggers. This is the first round of the playoffs for Maple Mountain. It is up at Weber State University in Ogden. Going to be an exciting game for you. And again, the winner of this game will be playing down in Southern Utah on the campus of Southern Utah down in Cedar City. If Spanish Fork is able to win this one, they will be, from what I've heard on good authority, they will be playing Ridgeline. That game would be on Thursday, February 28th at 5:50 p.m. An absolutely exciting week of basketball here for you on Spanish Fork 17. A couple big wins for Maple Mountain against Provo, one of them a triple overtime thriller. This one, an overtime thriller for the Lady Dons. If you love basketball, this has been the right week for you here on Spanish Fork 17, and we hope that there will be more of it next week, especially if the Lady Dons are able to take this one. A three-point advantage for them here in overtime with 1:19 left, 63-60. Back into Bowman, who swings it over to Allen. Back to Bowman. Cardoza trapped, but fouled. Nice job there by Cardoza to just protect the ball. Go ahead and take the foul. Now she will be at the free throw line. She will be shooting two. And she gets the first. That is 17 points in the game for Haley Cardoza. She is now tied with Erica Allen for the game lead for the Lady Dons. And that one is going to be off the rim. And is going to be off the hands of Taylor Stewart. A 1-for-2 trip there for Cardoza at the line. Score is now 64-60. A 4-point lead for the Lady Dons. Flyers needing to fly the ball around and hope that they can get something going. And that is exactly what they get. A huge three from Mel Allo. She now has 8 points in the game. None bigger than those three that now cuts this lead down to one. A scramble for the ball. And they are going to say that it is Spanish Fork ball. An almost costly turnover there for the Lady Dons, as the Flyers would have been running on that one with a fast break opportunity. Instead, they're able to maintain possession and maintain their 1-point advantage. They get it into Cardoza, who hands it off to Allen. 35 seconds left here in overtime. The Lady Dons clinging to that 1-point lead, and there is a foul. A reach in by Schwalger. That's going to send Rosma to the line. Rosma on the line here for a couple of key free throws here with 32 seconds left. She leaves it short. That one off the front iron. Again, score 64-63, a 1-point lead here for the Lady Dons over the Dixie Flyers. 32 seconds left here in overtime. A trip to Cedar City on the line. And it hits every part of the rim but does not fall. 0-for-2 trip there for Rosma, unable to extend this lead. 25 seconds left for the Flyers to get an answer here. It's kicked over to Schaefer. Schaefer to Allah, who gets it back. Bundy with it now to Schwalger. 10 seconds left in this one. Allo for three. Off the front iron and rebounded by Spanish Fork. And that is most likely going to be it, folks. A huge rebound there off the missed three by Allo. It is going to send Gentry Rosma once more back to the line. A big rebound for her after missing
her two free throw shots. She is the one that's able to come up big with that rebound, gets fouled, and can essentially ice this game for the Lady Dons. 3.3 seconds left in this one. Here is her first. Off the back iron. Three straight misses from the free throw line there for Rosma. Just got to get herself composed, as you see there. Taking her time, making sure she can get this second one. So it gives the Dons a two-point lead. And there is a little girl on the court. Wandered away a little bit there. That's fun. She's not having any of it. Still stomping around. Gotta love that. And here we go. Second free throw here for Rosma. This one is also off the rim. 0 for 4. Couple ticks. And it is short. And that is going to be the game. What a finish here for the Spanish Fork Lady Dons. Able to come back from a six-point deficit in the fourth quarter, forces the overtime, and then is able to come up big here in overtime and gets the one-point lead over the Dixie Flyers. They will be heading to Cedar City on the campus of Southern Utah and continuing on in the playoffs. They will be, as I said, most likely playing Ridgeline in that game. Wow, what an absolutely great victory here for the Lady Dons. As you can see in here, the celebration is fully on. Again, the final for this one is 64-63, a huge win for the Spanish Fork Lady Dons over the Dixie Flyers. Great contributions from Haley Cardoza and Erica Allen, both with 17 points in this one. Again, they will have the opportunity now to head to the second round of the state playoffs, where they will be playing Ridgeline down on the campus of Southern Utah University. Again, as you see here, that next game will be on Thursday, February 28th at 5:50 p.m. The Lady Dons able to come up victorious in this one, so we will give you coverage of that game here on Spanish Fork 17 on the cable channel. If you want to see that one online, you will need to go to KSL and Deseret Digital to be able to watch it there. Again, a huge victory here tonight for the Spanish Fork Dons. For our Spanish Fork 17 crew, I am Andrew LaRose. Thank you for joining us, and we will see you next time on Spanish Fork 17.